June Brunskill has spent the last two Christmases alone in her room.
I was very sad there for a while. You did get down.
She lives at Baptist Care's Gracewood Centre, which was recently in lockdown for 6 weeks.
When they were isolated to reduce the risk of COVID spreading, meals were served in their rooms and she ate on her bed on a tray, much like in a hospital environment. If anyone knows my mum, they know she loves to chat. And so isolating her was a punishment.
From day trips to bingo, normally life at Gracewood is pretty good. But when there's an outbreak, everything disappears.
They're feeling like their rights have been taken away from them. And even though they're safe and the staff are doing exactly what they can do to help protect them, it's like being in a prison.
I used to go and walk a lot in the corridors, and that affected me a lot when I couldn't do that. I felt as though, oh, I'm going crazy, because we couldn't do any activities either.
They get very upset, they get very teary. They say, why? Why I'm here? Why I'm sitting here in my room? Why I cannot go out? It is very hard and very sad and it hurts a lot.
Miriam Camisi has been working for Baptist Care for 15 years.
That's very nice. You should do that every day and do some colourful.
She says it's not uncommon for her to work double or even triple shifts.
You guys try to see the roster. Sometimes it's only two nurses, three nurses, but the job have to be done. The staff are very, very tired. It hurts my heart just to see my residents suffering as well.
Baptist Care has been in business for over 76 years, and we have never seen such significant staff turnover. It's tough out there.
A few weeks ago, all of Baptist Care's homes were in lockdown because 280 employees weren't able to work and 55 residents had COVID.
We've had accountants, we've had chaplains, we've had IT people volunteering their Christmas holiday break to step up and fill the gaps. The real issue is, though, is that all of our staff are exhausted. We can't ask them to continue to do this. It's not sustainable.
The first outbreak at an Australian aged care facility was at a Baptist Care home. Charles says even though it's been nearly 2 years, the sector is no closer to managing this crisis.
The aged care system is fundamentally broken. It's underfunded, under-resourced. Asking the sector to keep doing what it has been doing and expecting a different result is frankly the definition of insanity.
The government has set up a task force to investigate COVID deaths in aged care, and workers are set to receive two incentive payments of up to $400. But will that really help?
It's an insult for us. There is nothing. I get absolutely angry and upset because they don't have any idea about aged care.
My daughters work in retail, in part-time jobs. Now, they can earn as much, if not more, than our terrific, experienced, skilled frontline workers. There is something fundamentally wrong with the system.
Charles backs calls for significantly higher wages and increased funding for the sector.
We are at breaking point. We need to see action, and we need to see action now.
We cannot push through anymore. We do our job. It's time for the government to do their job.
June is finally allowed visitors, but only one at a time, and face shields and masks are compulsory. It's not ideal, but it's better than nothing.
They need that physical interaction. Sometimes the words aren't enough, but just the physical touch is so reassuring for someone, to give them a hug, touch them on the hand, and that's what the families haven't been able to do.
Lisa's great hope is that her mother doesn't spend the rest of her years in lockdown.
She said that she just doesn't want to go on. That, you know, what is there to live for if you can't go out, if you can't enjoy the company of people? You can't go for a walk. What's the point of life?
I mean, the rest of Australia seems to be getting back to some sort of normality. This hidden torture is an absolute disgrace.
And what are you calling the torture, though?
Like
the,
is locking it... people in their rooms and not letting them walk up and down corridors because there's been a COVID outbreak. And we don't get told about it. Until you take a camera in there and look at it, we don't know about it. Unless you've got a relative in there, you don't know about it. You don't hear about it. We're all going about our normal business. These poor people, they're being treated disgracefully.
It was really fascinating reading comments from Brett Sutton over the weekend. So he was the chief... Health?
Chief Health Officer.
Medicals federal level, right? Yeah, health. In Victoria, who was, like, really hardcore through all of 2020, 2021, and he said the balance has to change because the idea of them not having access to people is a health issue and you can't just say it's all about counting deaths now. Now, when he's talking that way and he's encouraging the aged care homes to start factoring in that balance more, I reckon there is that moment, I think, where it's shifting. Yeah.